Did you know there are secret codes that unlock extraordinary possibilities on your phone?
Checking your signal strength, improving phone call quality, and shutting down one of the number one ways hackers track you.
There are tons of USSD codes that unlock hidden features on your phone, like dialing *3001 #12345 #* unlocks this hidden phone menu.
It's called field test mode. At first glance, it might look overwhelming, but here's how it's really useful.
Field test mode can show your phone's exact signal strength and signal quality. Scroll down, under LTE, look for RSRP, RSRQ, SYN, R. Then first, take a look at RSRP.
RSRP stands for Reference Signal Received Power, AKA your signal strength.
Anything greater than minus 90 is excellent, anything lower than minus 120 is bad, and anything in the middle is fine.
So greater than minus 90, we're talking minus 85.
Right now, this phone's RSRP is minus 116. It's fine, but it's really not that good.
The next thing to look at is RSRQ, which stands for Reference Signal Received Quality, AKA signal quality.
Greater than minus 12 is good. Lower than minus 12, not so good. The RSRQ on our Ting phone, minus 13, not great. On my personal Verizon phone, minus 21.
That's awful.
That's abysmal. Now, one thing to keep in mind, maybe you're actually going apartment hunting and you need to have good cell service in your apartment. Pop open the field test mode app, say, oh my God, the cell service here is terrible.
If only Walter White knew about this one and Breaking Bad, could have saved some tinfoil.
If your call quality is poor, you might be able to fix it with this next code.
And that code is *3370#. This turns on enhanced full rate codec for some phone models.
And there's a big misconception about what this actually does. Some people say it saves battery life and improves your cell signal.
But that isn't true. Enhanced full rate codec improves sound quality on your phone calls at the expense of battery life.
If you're looking to maximize battery life, dial *#4720#, then hit the dial button. Your call quality won't be as good, but do people even make phone calls anymore?
I think they do.
Nope, nobody.
So try entering the code on your phone and let us know if it works for you in the comments section below.
Next, let's talk about some codes that'll help you figure out if your phone is being tracked.
And they have to do with call forwarding. We talked a little bit about call forwarding in our video about signs your phone is being tracked.
Call forwarding doesn't always appear in your phone settings, but you still might be able to enable or disable it.
There are unique codes to check your call forwarding status for different types of calls.
But you can check them all at once by dialing *#21#, and then hitting the dial button.
But what if some call forwarding settings are enabled on your phone, maybe without your knowledge or consent?
You can turn off all call forwarding by dialing *#002#, then hitting the dial key.
But call forwarding can be useful too.
Maybe you want to play a prank on your coworker. What you need to do to forward your phone calls to another phone number is dial *72, followed by the phone number you want to forward calls to.
Call forwarding can be more nuanced and useful. Let's say you have a camp in the Adirondacks with no cell coverage, but you do have a landline in that camp. There's a call forwarding code that lets you forward phone calls from your phone to a landline or a different phone number, but only if your phone isn't in range of a cell tower.
And that code is *#62#, followed by the phone number you want to forward calls to when your phone is unreachable. And when you're done, you can turn this off by dialing ##62#.
After you enter these codes, maybe you want to get in touch with your wireless carrier. Fortunately, there's an easy way to do that.
And there is. You can dial 611 on your phone and get in touch with your carrier's customer support.
This next code is for all you aspiring prank callers.
Please hold for a collect call from Joe Mama.
Dial *67, followed by the phone number you want to call to hide your caller ID.
There are several third-party apps that try to sell you this feature, but you can do it for free because the FCC says it's the law. Thanks, FCC.
#31# may also help you make anonymous calls in Europe or Canada.
Or in the UK or Ireland, try adding 141 to the beginning of a phone number. Let us know what code works for you in your country, and we'll get a list going in the description section below.
Or if there's someone in your contacts you always want to call anonymously, you can add *67 to the front of their phone number in contacts. In the phone app, tap on the contacts tab at the bottom of the screen. Tap on the contact whose number you want to call anonymously. Tap the edit button upper right-hand corner of the screen, and then add *67 to the front of their phone number.
Depending on your carrier, you can also hide your caller ID in the settings app.
Verizon, for example, doesn't allow us to do this, but Ting does. So if we close out of the phone app, open settings, scroll down, tap on phone, and then tap show my caller ID. And if you want to hide your caller ID, just turn off the switch next to show my caller ID.
On the flip side, if you've hidden your caller ID from everyone, but you want to make an exception and show just one person your phone number, you could do that too.
Just dial star 82, followed by the phone number you want to call.
And maybe you were just on the receiving end of an anonymous phone call.
Then star 57 might be for you. This code activates call capture.
Dialing star 57 after receiving a harassing or threatening phone call will request that the phone call be recorded and stored by your phone company.
Call trace isn't available in every single area, and it's not offered by every single phone provider, and it may require an extra subscription or a fee.
Want a subscription without additional fees? Click that big subscribe button right below the video.
After using call trace, you do need to file a police report, as law enforcement will only act if there is a formal police report.
Unfortunately, there's a catch. This is a landline only code. So if you receive a harassing or threatening phone call on your mobile phone, call your wireless carrier, and don't be afraid to file a police report to protect yourself.
But some carriers make it very easy to block spam texts and spam calls on your phone, like T-Mobile and some of its MVNOs like Ting. You can dial #787# to see if scam block is on. Thanks for checking your scam block status. Scam block is turned off. Fortunately, they give us the code to turn it on.
Well, gee willikers, David, let's turn it on.
Dial #662#, hit the dial key to turn it on.
Check out our other video in the card above to learn about more spam blocking tips.
This next phone code is used by the most powerful people in the country. But before we tell you about that, we want to tell you about our membership program. Click that big join button below this video. You'll get access to custom badges and emojis, PDFs for some of our videos, and a lot more.
Let's get back to the powerful people you were talking about.
The most powerful people in this country, including the President of the United States, have access to the Nationwide Wireless Priority Service.
It's a system in the United States that allows high-priority emergency phone calls to avoid congestion on wireless networks.
Perfect.
So if Joe Biden wants to call somebody at a football game, he can totally, you know, do that.
The Wireless Priority Service is only authorized for national security and emergency preparedness personnel, including
executive leadership and policymakers like the President of the United States and members of Congress,
disaster response, military command and control, public health, safety and law enforcement command, public services, utilities and public welfare, and disaster recovery. Unfortunately, we weren't able to fund a successful congressional campaign to really demo this feature for you, but hypothetically, if you were a member of Congress, you could just dial *272, followed by the phone number you wanted to call.
But if you're a member of Congress who's watching this video right now, feel free to record yourself using this feature and send it to us. We will be glad to feature you in a future video.
This next code is really useful for anyone looking to switch carriers or sell their phone. Typing *#06# displays your phone's IMEI number. Wireless carriers, for example, use IMEIs to see if your phone is compatible with their network.
With eSIM-only phones on the horizon, IMEIs are more important than ever. IMEIs are now like the home address of your phone, so that when you receive a phone call, your carrier knows what phone to send it to.
You can also check your phone's IMEI in the settings app, but it's buried pretty deep, and I think it gets displayed better here.
iPhone users may find this next code useful.
Dialing *#07# takes you to the legal and regulatory settings on your iPhone.
It might seem like we're trying to lengthen this video with boring, obscure tips.
But some of this information, like the warranty information, can be really useful.
Especially if you're trying to fall asleep, and this next code unlocks a useful calling feature.
Dialing *#43# turns on call waiting, allowing you to receive another phone call while you're already on the phone.
But my phone already does that, and so does yours probably.
This is a feature we want to show you how to turn off in case you find those beeps distracting. So we tap dismiss, then dial *#43#, hit the dial key. That'll turn off call waiting.
That'll prevent you from being distracted on some incoming calls, but what about preventing outgoing calls?
Maybe I'm passing my phone to David and I don't want him to call Miss Cleo for $3 a minute. He told me to say this. I don't know what that is.
Call me now for your free reading.
But maybe you just don't trust the person you're handing your phone to. First dial *33*, then a PIN number like 1234, then pound, then press the dial button. At the top of the screen, you'll see setting activation succeeded, voice call barring all outgoing.
It's important to set a PIN here that you know and remember, because if you don't, then when he gives me the phone, I can just turn it off.
Yeah, so 1234, probably not the most secure code. I think most people will crack that one.
Yeah, just don't forget it. Otherwise, you have to go to your carrier and then explain this to them.
And they're going
to
say, like,
you did what?
Yeah, they'll be like, who's Miss Cleo?
Right,
because the customer support rep will be young.
Don't make me take you to church, young man.
And when you get your phone back, you can disable this feature by dialing #33* followed by the PIN number you set, then pound, then press dial.
This next code is a bit controversial and possibly a bit dangerous, so don't dial it, depending on where you live.
In some states, dialing *77 turns on anonymous call rejection, allowing you to block calls from people without a caller ID. Pretty useful.
But in other states, it calls the police. So don't dial it unless you're sure that it's gonna do the anonymous call rejection thing in your state.
Earlier, we talked about how these codes can be used to figure out if your phone is being tracked. There are plenty more ways to figure that out and how to stop trackers for good. Check out that video next.